Bob and Judy Myers were in their new home in the canyon for only 6 months when the storm hit in 1969. In the dark of the night, she heard two homes across the way pulling apart like orange crates in the water. She went into labor. They were not panicked because their neighbor above was a chiropractor and he knew how to deliver babies. Water had been gathered from the spring above the house, and a big flashlight was sitting atop several books of knowledge to provide light in the bedroom. As the morning came, two doctors had hiked into the canyon from downtown to help at the fire hall, which had just suffered a deadly slide. But they did not tell Judy about it. One doctor stayed with Judy and gave her a shot to slow the labor. He recommended getting a helicopter to airlift her out of the canyon. The helicopter came in the afternoon about 2. The doctor told Judy, "Don't look down. Close your eyes as you go up." But she had to look. The blades of the helicopter sent the rain in a circle, as well as the clothes of everyone on the ground. As she looked down into the funnel, it felt like the Wizard of Oz. As she approached the helicopter, she was suddenly brought back down to the ground, for the cable had caught and could not get her into the aircraft. They had to cut the cable fast because the helicopter was losing its buoyancy in the deep canyon. 2 hours later, the helicopter returned, and she was successfully pulled into the aircraft. As she laid on the floor of the helicopter in a wire basket, 6 young Marines were looking down at her. One leaned over and said, in a southern accent, "Missy, don't you be afraid. I'm a medic." Judy replied, "Don't you worry. I'm keeping the baby till we get to town." The young man threw his arms in the air and said, "Oh, thank God." Bob and Judy tried to find the Marine unit that helped them that day. Bob wrote the commanding general of the 3rd Marine Air Wing at the El Toro Marine Base this message: "Citizens of Silverado will long associate the sound of rotor blades as the sound of comfort and safety, especially my wife and I. Judy was evacuated while in labor 7 hours before our first child was born. I believe she amply described her first impression of the crew as she was winched into the craft. Angels in flight helmets."